We now return to engineering disasters on Modern Marvels. Computers. We've all come to accept the often frustrating problems that go with them. Bugs, viruses, and software glitches are small prices to pay for the convenience. But in high-tech and high-speed military and space program applications, the smallest problem can be magnified into disaster. On June 4th, 1996, scientists prepared to launch an unmanned Ariane 5 rocket. It was carrying scientific satellites designed to establish precisely how the Earth's magnetic field interacts with solar winds. The rocket was built for the European Space Agency and lifted off from its facility on the coast of French Guiana.
At about 37 seconds into the flight, they first noticed something was going wrong, that the nozzles were swiveling in a way they really shouldn't. Around 40 seconds into the flight, clearly the vehicle was in trouble, and that's when they made the decision to destroy it. The range safety officer, with tremendous guts, pressed the button, blew up the rocket before it could become a hazard to public safety.
This was the maiden voyage of the Ariane 5, and its destruction took place because of a flaw embedded in the rocket's software.
The problem on the Ariane was that there was a number that required 64 bits to express, and they wanted to convert it to a 16-bit number. They assumed that the number was never going to be very big, that most of those digits in the 64-bit number were zeros. They were wrong.
The inability of one software program to accept the kind of number generated by another was at the root of the failure. Software development had become a very costly part of new technology. The Ariane 4 rocket had been very successful, so much of the software created for it was also used in the Ariane 5.
The basic problem was that the Ariane 5 was faster, accelerated faster, and the software hadn't accounted for that.
The destruction of the rocket was a huge financial disaster, all due to a minute software error. But this wasn't the first time data conversion problems had plagued modern rocket technology.
In 1991, with the start of the first Gulf War, the Patriot missile experienced a similar kind of number conversion problem. And as a result, 28 American soldiers were killed and about 100 others wounded when the Patriot, which was supposed to protect against incoming Scuds, failed to fire a missile.
When Iraq invaded Kuwait and America launched Desert Storm in early 1991, Patriot missile batteries were deployed to protect Saudi Arabia and Israel from Iraqi Scud missile attacks. The Patriot is a U.S. medium-range surface-to-air system manufactured by the Raytheon Company.
The size of the Patriot interceptor itself is it's about roughly 20 feet long, and it weighs about 2,000 pounds. And it carries a warhead of about, I think it's roughly 150 pounds. And the warhead itself is a high explosive, which has fragments around it. The casing of the warhead is designed to act like buckshot.
The missiles are carried 4 per container and are transported by a semi-trailer.
The Patriot anti-missile system goes back at least 20 years now. It was originally designed as an air defense missile to shoot down enemy airplanes. In the first Gulf War, when that war came along, the Army wanted to use it to shoot down Scuds, not airplanes. The Iraqi Air Force was not so much of a problem, but the Army was worried about Scuds. And so they tried to upgrade the Patriot.
Intercepting an enemy missile traveling at Mach 5 was going to be challenging enough. But when the Patriot was rushed into service, the Army was not aware of an Iraqi modification that made their Scuds nearly impossible to hit.
What happened is the Scuds that were coming in were unstable. They were wobbling. The reason for this was the Iraqis, in order to get 600 kilometers out of a 300 kilometer range missile, took weight out of the front warhead. They made the warhead lighter. So now the Patriot's trying to come at the Scud, and most of the time, the overwhelming majority of the time, it would just fly by the Scud.
Once the Patriot system operators realized the Patriot missed its target, they detonated the Patriot's warhead to avoid possible casualties if it was allowed to fall to the ground.
That was what most people saw as big fireballs in the sky and misunderstood as intercepts of Scud warheads.
Although in the night skies, Patriots appeared to be successfully destroying Scuds, at Dahran, there could be no mistake about its performance. There, the Patriots' radar system lost track of an incoming Scud and never launched due to a software flaw. It was the Israelis who first discovered that the longer the system was on, the greater the time discrepancy became due to a clock embedded in the system's computer.
About 2 weeks before the tragedy in Dahran, the Israelis reported to the Defense Department that the system was losing time. After about 8 hours of running, they noticed that the system was becoming noticeably less accurate. The Defense Department responded by telling all of the Patriot batteries to not leave the systems on for a long time. They never said what a long time was. 8 hours, 10 hours, 1,000 hours. Nobody knew.
The Patriot battery stationed at the barracks at Dahran and its flawed internal clock had been on over 100 hours on the night of February 25th.
It tracked time to an accuracy of about a tenth of a second. Now, a tenth of a second is an interesting number because it can't be expressed in binary exactly, which means it can't be expressed exactly in any modern digital computer. It's hard to believe, but use this as an example. Let's take the number one-third. One-third cannot be expressed in decimal exactly. One-third is 0.333 going on for infinity. There's no way to do that with absolute accuracy in decimal. That's exactly the same kind of problem that happened in the Patriot. The longer the system ran, the worse the time error became.
After 100 hours of operation, the error in time was only about one-third of a second. But in terms of targeting a missile traveling at Mach 5, it resulted in a tracking error of over 600 meters. It would be a fatal error for the soldiers at Dahran.
What happened is a Scud launch was detected by early warning satellites, and they knew that the Scud was coming in their general direction. They didn't know where it was coming.
It was now up to the radar component of the Patriot system, defending Dahran, to locate and keep track of the incoming enemy missile.
The radar was very smart. It would actually track the position of the Scud and then predict where it probably would be the next time the radar sent a pulse out. That was called the range gate.
Then once the Patriot decides enough time has passed to go back and check the next location for this detected object, it goes back. So when it went back to the wrong place, it then sees no object, and it decides that there was no object, it was a false detection, and drops the track.
The incoming Scud disappeared from the radar screen, and seconds later, it slammed into the barracks. The Scud killed 28 and was the last one fired during the first Gulf War. Tragically, the updated software arrived at Dahran the following day. The software flaw had been fixed, closing one chapter in the troubled history of the Patriot missile. Patriot is actually an acronym for Phased Array Tracking Intercept of Target.